Welcome at tutorial number 42 of the EEP10 Model Railway Simulator. We are in the midst of a project to build a two-track turnout with a control circuit, and in this video we are going to build the control circuit itself. If you are building with me, let's open up the last saved file that looks like this. We had the track, we have the signals, and we have four trains already in there. And now let me open our design. That is, we have to build one of these pillars, and then the other four we can copy, the other three. So we need to carefully reconstruct this in EEP. Well, okay, we start with a junction, then we get a junction in 90 degrees, and we also need a mirrored one of that, and then some straight stuff that we can easily remember. So let's build it somewhere over here. I go to street mode because we built a control circuit with the Veldweg. First thing to do is add a small length of five, let's zoom in, length of five junction. Yes, five. And then we needed again a junction but with a curve upwards. That is a 90 degree curve. Let's give it a length of 10. And we also already know that we need a mirrored copy of that. So, oh, that is wrong. That is not good. I need a mirrored copy of that, but that needs to be a forward mirrored copy. So, and let me move that to store that for later use. Okay, this one needed to be over here. And then we need again a junction with a length of 10, but this time a straight one. Yes, that's good. And if I connect that here, let's see how many do we need. This is 1, 2, 3, and then a normal straight. Okay, that is means I have to copy this one forward 2 times, and then I have 3. Now I need a normal straight of 10. And well, then we have a lot of components already available. I need a curve of 180 degrees, but that is a negative curve, minus 180, length 20. Yes, looks good. I'm going to place that here, but let me first create a mirrored forward copy so that I can keep copying it. Yes. And then also, well, that was wrong. I first needed to click this guy and then keep mirrored, making mirrored copies. Yes. Another one over there. Click, copy, another one over there. Click, copy, another one over there. Okay. And now I need my mirrored junction, but I cannot connect that because I am going to connect it then to an endpoint, and we should never do that. So what I am going to do, I have enough of these. I am going to reduce this angle to 90. Give it a length of 10, and that gives me the piece that I can connect over here, and then first connect another one of these. Let's make a right copy, and then I can remove an okay and a forward copy of that. I also need a forward copy of that. Now I can remove this one. Just delete it, and I can backward copy this one. Okay, that's good. Now I can delete this intermediate rail that I don't need anymore. And now I should be able to insert this one because I have everything in place to let it snap. Yes, and all I need now is one more straight at the bottom. Okay, and that is obviously a lot too long, but we can shorten it and hope that it snaps. Well, it doesn't, and that is always a problem. You never know when things are going to snap. Yes, now they do. Oh, and I forgot here now, these guys still have to do that. Make a left copy, and then we can move it over there. That should snap, yes, and a few forward copies should do that trick. And then a normal straight that we have to left copy and move over there. This should be our circuit, and this one is not needed. So this is the beginning and this is the end. Are all the switches, the junctions at nicely visible? Well, these ones are okay. This one I would have liked the switch to be at the bottom, which is the right side. Yes, that's good. And this switch is already at the right side. Okay, I think that everything is okay. That one we don't need anymore too, and I am going to simply select that whole thing and then give it store it as a block, speicher a block, and give it a name. How shall we call it? Pillar. Let me call that control. Pillar four loops, yeah, pillar four, okay. That is done. What I need now is a few copies of it. Well, that should be easy. I can just select, yeah, I can of course now open my just saved block and say, okay, I want this control pillar four, and then I can move it, and now I have to be careful to shift click. Oh, why is it moving over there? I have no idea. I don't know why that is happening. All of a sudden it's decided to rotate. I want it to snap here. Yeah, okay, that's better. Yes, and then another one. Okay, let's just do that again. Block öffnen, control 4, and I want it to snap over here, so I hit the shift key. Yes, it stops moving. That should do it. And then the last one, open the block and control pillar 4 and start to move and hit the shift key, and it stops moving, and then I double click. Well, that should do it. Do we need a loop around for the control car to run around? No, because we can say that our car should run around by itself, and there is a way to do that. That is virtuele Verbindung, yeah? I get two purple arrows that on the video you possibly can never see. I want to connect this one to this one. Okay, now the symbol has changed to again something that you probably cannot see, but let's test that out in 3D. Let's go to our overview camera and then move in to our control circuit a bit. If we place a control car there, let's go to rolling material, Straßenbahn. No, Straßenverkehr, and then the bottom, Schaltauto. I can place that thing over there. Let's call it control. Well, Schaltauto was okay too, of course. Let's zoom in to see if it has the right orientation. Well, it looks like it has the right orientation. Let me give it maximum speed and see if it pops up at the other end of my well, I don't see it back, so it disappeared in doing a lot of running around because I forgot to switch the switches. Okay, this switch is that way, and this switch is that way, and also this switch is that way. I don't think this control car has really a very high speed, so we hope that it can manage to control this this junction. We will have to wait and see, because in the next video we are going to work on all the turnouts that we have created and add the signals for all of them. So see you back in the next video, where we are going to let our control circuit that we just built do some work.